1, you'll find these words. But we know that if our earthly house, this tabernacle, were dissolved, we have the building of God, that house not made with hands, eternal in the heavens. And then Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, at the front door of the Bible reads, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground, and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life, and man became a living soul." I want to talk today from this subject, this old house slash the body, the soul, and the spirit of Howard Creasy Jr. This old house slash the body, soul, and spirit of Howard Creasy Jr. After this earth, like a spark of incandescent mass, was unformed matter, had been hammered from the angle of omnipotence and spitting off into space, after life had emerged from the abyss of darkness and went striding across the immensity at the rate of 186,000 miles per second, after night and day had been cut from 24 hours by the sword of wisdom and the measure of love, after the formation of the heavens with their glittering stars, gigantic constellations, dancing asteroids, flaming meteors, flying comets, and the great Milky Way, after the waters had taken their strategic places in the bowels of the earth, after all of the animals had walked, creeped, and roamed the earth in their first adventure of existence, after the fowl were dressed in their feathers of beauty, while birds split the air with their wings, and the flowers sprayed forth their sweet fragrances as trees looked all day as they lifted their leafy arms to pray, it was then that God, the strong one, came walking down the purple steeps of glory and summed up the creation by announcing to the triune, "Let us make man." Yes, God summed up the creation with the creation of a man. It was the formation of a physique, the shaping of a character, the production of a being, the creation of an image, the molding of a figure. It was the fashioning of a unique personality. It was the birth of a man. The Bible teaches that God created man in his image. So the question arises, what then is the image of God? God's image is that he is three persons, but one God. He is Father, Son, Holy Spirit, all one God. As close as I can come to describe what that really is saying, it's like ice, snow, and sleet. Three different forms of water, but all three are water. It's like the three holes on a pretzel. Each hole is separate and distinct within itself, but it is all on one pretzel. It is something like that, that we in the image of God, three, are also three entities. The Bible here describes explicitly for us the three entities. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 7, "And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground," that's body, "and breathed into his nostrils the breath of life," that's spirit, "and man became a living soul," that's soul. Listen, in 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23, it puts it this way. "And the way the very God of peace satisfy you wholly, and I pray God your whole spirit and soul and body be preserved blameless unto the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. The order that the scriptures puts it in is spirit, soul, and body. Ladies and gentlemen, I beg you today to privy me just for a moment to homiletically arrange this passage in the reverse order. I think that if I am privileged to show you not necessarily the scriptorial way, but scripture in the reverse, instead of seeing it as spirit, and then soul, and then body, look at it with me as body, soul, and spirit. Because I want you to know today, at this homegoing celebration of Howard Creasy Jr., to come to understand what you are and who you are, so that you can then grasp why you are. So based on my homiletical arrangement, I have three outlines. One, the marvel of the human body. Roman numeral two, the magnificence of the human soul. And then finally, the mystery of the human spirit. Point one, the marvel of the human body. Psalm chapter 139, verse 14 says, I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Listen, marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well the marvel of the human body. According to physiology, man can sprint at almost 25 miles an hour. He can throw a ball in excess of 100 miles per second, high jump over 7 feet. Man's heart is capable of pumping, working 6,000 hours as it makes 4,320 strokes, pumping the equivalent of 15 gallons of blood every moment. Your heart is about the size of your fist, and it weighs less than a pound, but yet it pumps 1.5 million gallons of blood each and every year. There are 5 million corpuscles, 25 trillion red cells that carries oxygen to all parts of the body. There are about 25 billion white cells, which are like soldiers of the body, that protects and ward and fight off diseases from infesting our bodies. When a baby is born, that baby generally has about 305 bones, but the more that baby grows toward adulthood, the more those bones fuse together so that when it becomes grown, it has 206 bones, 650 muscles, and 100 joints. The marvel of the human body. Look at the human eye. There's no scientific instrument as sensitive to light as is your eye. Of course, mankind has made many cameras, and these cameras exert different kinds of light at night, but there is no camera on the market like the human eye. Your eye is self-adjusting. Your eye works automatically. Your eye is constantly focusing. Your eye takes all of its pictures in color. Your eye instantaneously develops what it is that it sees. No wonder the psalmist says, yeah, I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Just trying to show you the marvel of the human body. And then there's the nervous system. We talk these days about having my laptop. I've got to get me a laptop. And do you have a laptop? Well, I thought I'd let you know we all have a head top. Because there's simply no computer with the capability connected all the marvel of the human body. Here it is, Genesis chapter 2, the 8th law, verse 7. And the Lord God formed man of the dust of the ground. From the dust of the ground. From the dust of the ground. Out of the dust of the ground, God tenderly worked on man until he was satisfied with his work. James Weldon Johnson puts it this way, like a mammy bending over her babe, God kneeled down into the dust of the ground. This is to say, ladies and gentlemen, that if we come from the dust of the ground, that all of the elements that are in the earth are also elements that are in our bodies. Dr. P. Lawson, the English savant back in the 20th century, somewhere during the 1940s, said these words, and I quote, "The average man weighing 140 pounds is composed of enough water to fill a 10-gallon barrel. He has enough fat to make several bars of soap, enough carbon to make 9,000 lead pencils, enough phosphorus to make 2,200 match heads, enough magnesium for one good dose of salt. He has enough iron to make a medium-sized nail, enough lime to whitewash a chicken coop, enough sulfur to rid one dog of all of his fleas, and enough sugar to fill up one sugar shaker." But he goes on to say that if you break or decompose these elements down into dollars and cents, that it is worth in these inflationary times of the 21st century, 2011, $2.07 worth of dust. In other words, each of us are worth $2.07 worth of dust. And yet, we put ourselves to all kinds of trouble and do all kinds of expense just to keep about said in Matthew chapter 16, verse 26, but what does a man profit? He should gain the whole world and lose his own soul. Inside your body is the real you. Your persona, your personality, your idiosyncrasies, your proclivities, your humor, your winsomeness, your spiritual DNA, the you underneath the skin. That's why it's so important that your soul be saved. I'm tired of going to that old church. I'm sick of hearing about soul. But the greatest word you can ever hear, your soul.